What up, guys? Welcome back to another episode. My name is Eddie Bear, and today we will go full mobile. And this video is kind of like an inception video, so I'm doing two videos in one. So in today's video, I will give you a full review of the Luna display, and I will also show you how I edit this whole video I'm recording here on my iPhone XS in Adobe Rush. So this second video I will put out later will show you whether Adobe Rush is actually a good mobile companion. And while I'm recording the Luna review on my iPhone, I'm also recording the whole session on my Canon EOS R. So the rig I'm using today is my iPhone XS and the Joby Griptight Gorilla Pod, and also a Rode Lav Mic Plus in order to give you better audio so you don't have all the echoes out of my kitchen here. So with that said, let's roll the intro. So when you order your Luna display, this is all you're getting. So this little box here contains actually the whole thing, and it's really nice. I tend to carry around this with me in order to store the Luna display since it is so freaking small. You can see it here. This, by the way, is the USB-C version of the Luna display. And the only thing you need to do is to grab it, take your laptop and plug it right into it, and done. To connect your Luna display, you have two options. You are either having your iPad and also your MacBook in the same Wi-Fi, or you go back to the good old cable. I'm having here the USB-C and Lightning cable. I'm unfortunately not owning a new iPad where you have USB-C, because this would be awesome, because then I could use all my USB-C cables that I have lying around and just, you know, plug them in and I would be good to go. But unfortunately, for now, I have to stick with this cable here. So if I'm not having a Wi-Fi present, I just connect my iPad to my MacBook and I'm also good to go. The Luna display actually not only comes as a USB-C version, if you are having an older MacBook or a Mac or whatever, there is also a Thunderbolt 2 version. So both of them work the same way. You don't have any limitations whatsoever. So after Luna display launched automatically the Luna app on your MacBook or Mac, you head over to your iPad and launch the Luna display app here. It will connect to the nearest Luna display in its vicinity, and boom, here you go. Now you have your second desktop right at your hand. Here you can see the settings that are available with the Luna display, and here you can choose whether you want your second device on the right or on the left from your MacBook. Also, you can disable and enable Retina resolution. Since I'm having my iPad on the left, naturally I'm switching to the left side. And let me show you how the Retina resolution is looking on the iPad. So you can see that the writing is really clear. And especially when you open up a menu and check out the writing from the close, you can see that it is really clear. So good for longer working hours. If you disable the Retina resolution, it takes a moment to switch back. And you can see already on top that it's a bit pixelated compared to the Retina resolution. And also, if you take a close look on the menu, you can easily see that there is some pixelation going on here. Okay, so let's switch back to Retina right here and check out the custom settings. So with the custom settings, you can set your area where you want to transition to your second display. So this one here is fine with me. And if you head over to your iPad, you can see that there are certain available options regarding the resolution. So in order to show you how much the resolution is affecting your workspace, I'm using a standard Excel sheet. So this is how Excel looks if you open it up. And if I throw it over to the second display, you can see that in the stock resolution, it kinda is filling out the whole resolution of the display. So if I switch to the next or the second highest one, you can see that you have way more real estate to work with. So it kind of feels like a second display compared to your MacBook from the size of the Excel sheet itself. For the naked eye, it is still readable, but it starts to get really, really small. The moment I switch to the bigger one, it fills the whole screen and you don't have that amount of side real estate anymore as you had it before. It's still a decent size for projects that need a lot of real estate, and it will definitely help you to work on two really big displays if you are on the go. Now let's talk about the additional features that the Luna app is actually packing. So if you swipe from the left, you can see that you have your batteries displayed here, and you definitely need to keep your battery state in mind, because I noticed when I'm using the Luna display here, it will drain my iPad's battery rather quick. So I'm guessing you can get somewhere around 3 hours out of it. But after that, you will definitely need a power plug. Normally, if you're traveling and you have the time to work, you will find a power plug somewhere. Also, you can switch the arrangement down here. Also here on the side, you can see where your iPad is located transitioning wise to your MacBook. Okay, so now let's talk about the other features. So we all know macOS does not have a touch feature, does it? Well, with Luna display, I'm able to control my Mac through touch gestures. And it gets even better. You can see on top I have my Apple Pencil. Oh look, I even can use my Apple Pencil on this display. So this means if you are using it for creative purposes, you can use your Apple Pencil and also your hands to control the content on your display. Even though you can use your Apple Pencil to draw in Photoshop, you are unfortunately not able to use the force feature that you can use on the AstroPad Studio. But naturally, you can switch over to AstroPad Studio and you're good to go with the whole force push feature. Sure, the Luna display comes at a price, but the advantages you get out of it are really cool, and it is one of the most important things when I'm traveling that I'm taking with me, no matter what. So from my side, this is a huge thumbs up for the Astro HQ Luna display. So what do you think about the Luna display? Will it help you to get your work done when you're out and about? Hit me up in the comments and let me know what you think about it. I will also place the link to the Luna display down below. And with that said, make sure to hit the like button if you liked today's video, and also make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell in order to get notified whenever I post new reviews like this one today. So thanks again for watching, and I see you in the next one.